Now, you will have some listening activities. Please listen to your CD or the sound files, which you can find online. You can see this is called track 6. You'll play each one, and you'll listen to find out what's missing from the passage. Enter a little caret where you hear a missing word or words, and then put that in. So you've got some listening for B1, A, and B. And now let's go on to B2, contrasting verb forms. Now let's take a look at these. We won't do all of them, but we'll do a few. Let's say, choose the best answer to complete each conversation. The first part is about choosing simple past versus past continuous. In number one, we hear, where were you when I called you last night? I'm with friends. So what's the correct answer? Where were you when I called last night? I was having dinner with friends. Right, that's good. So that means I was having dinner. That means I started having dinner before you called. Then you called. But I didn't want to talk to you because I was in a restaurant with my friends. Or maybe I picked up and you heard other people talking in the background. We're not sure about that. But I was having dinner. We're sure about that. How about number two? Why did you apologize? Because I had made a mistake. What do you say? Realize. You're right. Because I realized that I had made a mistake. I realized at a past moment that I had made a mistake prior to my apology. Number three. I didn't hear the homework assignment. That's because you, I didn't hear the homework assignment. That's because what? You were sleeping. Yeah, you were sleeping. And the teacher told the homework assignment and you didn't hear it. Now, number four, why didn't she win the race? Right before she crossed the finish line, she, Right, because before she crossed the finish line, she fell. Simple past tense. So first question, she didn't win the race. Why didn't she win it? Before she crossed the finish line, simple past, she fell. Simple past. You have a few more to do that show you contrast between simple past and past progressive, and between simple past and present perfect. In B3, we look at simple past versus present perfect. We'll look at some of these conversations. We'll just do number one together, and then you can do the rest on your own. So let's look at the use of present perfect in the underlined sentence, and then I want you to think about this possibility. Can the present perfect sentence also be expressed in the simple past without changing the meaning? Why or why not? So an athlete and a coach are talking. And an athlete says, where's Jeff? And his coach says, he's in the hospital. He's broken his leg. You're starting the game tonight. Athlete answers, no problem. Okay, so an athlete, they're going to have a tournament or a game tonight. When the coach says he's in the hospital, that means he's talking about another player. Not this athlete, but another player named Jeff. He's broken his leg, and you're starting the game. So you know in a game, for example, basketball, there are only five men on the court at the same time, or women, depending if it's men or women, but it looks like it's a men's game here. And there are many other players who are sitting on the bench waiting to go in according to the coach's instructions. So when the coach says, you're starting the game, he's a starter, and he doesn't have to sit on the bench. Maybe he would have had to sit on the bench because Jeff was a starting player, but he has broken his leg. All right, so if we look at this verb tense, he's broken his leg, we see it's present perfect tense. And we need to look at this and say, well, okay, we know that he's broken his leg is present perfect tense because it happened sometime before now and it's related to the present. It's related to this game that they're playing. Is it possible? That's the question you need to ask yourself. Is it possible to express this same idea using the simple past? Yes. He broke his leg at a specific time in the past. So the simple past can be used. Now the present perfect can also be used because the condition is still the same in the present and a specific time is not mentioned in the sentence. So if the coach had said, he blah 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 his leg last night, if he used a past time sentence or a phrase like last night, he would have had to say he broke his leg last night. But since he didn't use a time phrase that shows past, he can use present perfect. He's broken his leg. So this sentence can be used can use either of the verb tenses. So give that a try. B4, using time clauses. Perhaps you've heard of Krista McAuliffe. Have you heard of her? She's an astronaut. So in 1986, Krista McAuliffe was an astronaut on the Challenger space shuttle, which exploded 73 seconds into flight. She lost her life. Now, complete these sentences about her life using either simple past or past continuous. Let's just do a couple of them, and then you can do the rest for homework. Let's do the first one. As a child, she interested in the space program. What do you say? Became. Okay, that's good. After she a NASA rocket launch. She saw a NASA rocket launch on TV. Number two. She at Concord High School when she about the NASA teacher in space program. Okay, you can tell she probably was teaching, right, continuously, when she learned, because this action interrupted or came while she was still teaching, while she learned about the NASA teacher in space program. All right, I'll let you do a few more on your own. But please know in the usage box, the usage note box, background events and events in sequence. So the simple past and the past continuous often occur together in narratives. The past continuous is used at the beginning of the passage to express background information. In other words, what was happening before the story began. And the simple past is used for events that move the narrative forward in a sequence. Now look at B5, describing a past event, and what I want you to think of it is that this page gives you some writing topic ideas. So at the end of the week, you're going to need to write something. You write a short essay, and here's a group of ideas. So you could think of an event that you witnessed, experienced, or heard about, and use one of the ideas below or your own idea, and think about the questions, make some notes. So in the box, you can see an important personal achievement. Think of something you've done. A family celebration. I'm sure you've had some celebrations with your family, and one is notable. An accident or a natural disaster. These happen all the time in different places of the world. A big sporting event. So if you're into athletics and sports, you can think of something like that. Here are some questions to help you flesh out your essay. When was the experience? Who were you with? Where were you? What was happening at the time? What did you do and how did you feel? So these are some questions to ask yourself as you are developing your essay. Now here's an example of a beginning of an essay about an accident. So here we have, it was cold, but the sun was shining on the day of the accident. My sister was driving, and I was riding in the back seat with my little brother. We were listening to music and chatting. Suddenly, the car hit an icy patch. When the car started to slide, My sister screamed. My father grabbed the wheel while my sister tried to da-da-da-da-da. So that is one way you can start an essay about an accident. Think of, you'll come back to this page when you are ready to write your essay.